Coach, certainly it was a game where your team would fight back and get close, and then it just seemed like you couldn't sustain it, couldn't have enough productive possessions, or they'd make a miss and you wouldn't get a defensive rebound, just kind of things that just kept you from ever getting over the top.
Yeah, Mike, you know, I thought we started out well. We had the lead midway through the first half, and then it started tipping in their favor. We missed a couple of one-on-ones consecutively. We missed two point-blank layups. I think it was Midgard. And we turned the ball over, which two or three of those resulted in transition shots for them. So they got their running game going. They were able to knock down some shots, get to the rim. And a 2 or 3 point lead for us became a 7 point deficit. We're down at halftime. We then played pretty well early in the second half. And just, you know, we had some opportunities, as you mentioned. But the bugaboo tonight, several things. You know, I do have 8 freshmen, but I felt like I had more than that tonight. You know, they've got to be more under control and knock down shots and knock down free throws for us to have a chance to beat a team like Louisiana Tech at this point. And then we got killed on the glass, minus 11. You know, there's so many times, and I got some guys that just aren't going physically enough for the basketball. They're shying away from some contact, or they're a little slow to retrieve it after checking out, or they forget to check out. So losing by 13 on the glass, obviously something that is killing me. And so we'll try to continue to address that. And finally, just 42% from the foul line. I mean, those three things to me are a recipe for disaster, whether you're home or away, especially when you're playing a team like Louisiana Tech. And I want to give them credit, man. They're a good basketball team. I see that team winning 20 plus and having a chance to go to the NCAA tournament, if not the NIT. I mean, that it's hard in that league to get multiple bids, but I mean, I see them having a great opportunity. I haven't seen the rest of the teams. I know Middle Tennessee's down a little bit. They lost everyone like we did. So they've been dominant in that league. Marshall will be good again. They did lose Penova, Western Kentucky probably. But that's a good basketball league. And we're going to see several more teams from that league. And Southern Miss, Rice, I think that's it. But yeah. That's a good basketball league, and Eric does a good job. He's got good players. I mean, their guards were better than our guards. Now, we're a little younger, but the Bracey kid in particular and Archibald were better than any two that we put out there tonight, even though they've got some experience on our guys. So they just I don't want to say they're better, but they played better for sure.
You mentioned after the exhibition game that, you know, all the work you do on free throws in practice and the routines you go through, and your guys have put up good numbers shooting in practice. And then it kind of went south against Oklahoma State in the scrimmage. And tonight again, you know, guys that we know are better free throw shooters than what they showed just couldn't come close sometimes.
Well, Mark, it says 1 for 4, but I believe he was 1 for 5. I know Chance, and I noticed this at halftime, did not go to the foul line, but it had Chance for 0 for 1. And I'm pretty sure Mark was 1 for 4, 1 for 5 at halftime. So,
The one they missed was one of Samaje's.
Samaje's, for 4,
and he was 3 for 5.
So Mark's 1 for 4. I mean, Dex is 4 for 9. The crazy thing is, we shoot pressure free throws in practice every day, and they generally do very well. And then we also do a deal where they have to make 30 out of 40. If they don't, they have to shoot 40 more. And you should see the numbers. I mean, it's 35 out of 40, 36 out of 40, 37 out of 40, 38 out of 40. But then against Oklahoma State, and I think Catawba, is when there's bright lights and people in the arena, we don't make them. So we're going to have to figure that out. And that's, again, I think that's being young, but Marcus McDuffie's, he's a 21-year-old senior.
Although 0 for 2 from the free throw line, I thought Eric Stevenson just gave you some really big time minutes.
Eric played pretty well. His grandpa's here. I think his mom's here, but his grandpa is definitely here. I thought he was one bright spot. Jamie Ishinique, yes, was a bright spot at times. Dexter started out gangbusters, but he made both of his field goals in the first 5 minutes, and then we didn't hear from him again. And Burton, you know, gets his 3 for 3, but other than that, offensively it was tough, and it's going to be tough. These guys are going to have to grow up. We're going to get better. Tomorrow's a Treat the Shockers really nice day. we go. It's an off day for basketball. I'm not allowed to do anything, but we'll be breaking down the film. And then we go to the Capitol, and then we go to the White House for behind-the-scenes tours. Now, I don't know what that means, but it's not the normal because the Pompeos have set it up for us.
Oh, wow.
We will see Mike and Susan at the White House, supposedly, and then we'll go to dinner with them tomorrow night. And right after that, on the way out of town for about an hour and a half, we're going to do the nighttime monument tour. So the Shockers will get a very nice day. And then it won't be quite as nice on Thursday, because Thursday will be video and practice for Providence. And it doesn't get any easier. That's all I'm going to tell you. Louisiana Tech is an excellent team, and I think they do a great job. I knew when I watched the film, I said, man, this is probably more than we can chew right now. But Providence is really good as well.
Well, Coach, thank you. We'll see you on the plane tomorrow.
Okay, thanks,
guys. Good luck.
Safe
trip.
Shocker head coach Greg Marshall and...